everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I wanted to do a quick video. We're gonna go take this old car for a drive, but the reason I'm doing this video is kind of show you guys, we got some cold weather heading our way after this weekend and into next week. Temperatures down in the teens. One day is for sure close to zero. We got some snow, everything. So I just kind of wanted to do a video on what I do with the old Ford here, just to keep it safe in this cold temperatures, and what we need to do as far as, I'm just gonna let it take it out for a drive, let it charge up today, let the battery charge up, get it good and charged. I just ran to the store, got some gas. We're gonna put some fresh gas in it, make sure the tank's pretty well full. And I wanted to show you guys a cold start and cold weather. It's about 35 degrees now. It was in the 20s last night. So let's get the camera rearranged around, and we'll get this thing started up, pulled out of the garage, put some gas in it, and we'll go for a drive. Okay, so we're in the car here, getting ready to start it. So what I wanted to show you guys is, on these cars, you know, you have your choke that you pull out, but also it acts, you can adjust the fuel mixture. So in the owner's manual, it'll tell you in cold weather, you turn your choke to rich, and that's would be counterclockwise. Rich clockwise is lean. So we're gonna, then we choke it, and then we'll start it. So put it in neutral. I've already got it turned to rich. I got my on, pull it out, see if she starts. Usually it takes a couple times. Now I'll be able to tell, but usually when I got it this rich, we'll let it warm up a little bit, and then as it, I can tell it'll start running rough, like it's getting too much fuel. And then what you do is you back it off. I usually go about a half to three quarters of a turn when it's cold out, when it's idling. That's when I turn this mixture back. It's gonna start leaning out and idling better. Now we'll just let her sit here, run a minute, and we'll pull it out, get some gas in it, and go for a drive. It's cold. So we'll get it, we'll get some gas in it, and take it out for a little drive. So the reason I'm doing this and not taking it to a gas station is because literally I didn't have enough gas in it to take it to the gas station to get gas in it. So I ran it into town, got some non-ethanol gas, and we'll put some gas in it this way, and this will give me enough gas to keep everything good while it's sitting in the cold weather. Just a tip, when you're storing these vehicles, older, even your lawnmower and stuff, it's good to keep I know a lot of people put stabilizer in, but the main thing is to keep your gas tanks full when they're going to be sitting a while, especially in cold weather. It'll keep condensation out of your, and keep water from getting into your gas system and everything like that when they're sitting for a while. So if you got, like me, if you got a cold snap or whatever, and you're, you know, you're going to be down a couple weeks, not really using whatever lawnmowers, I always try to keep the gas tanks full. And always too, if you're storing, use non-ethanol gas. I always run non-ethanol gas in this thing and my mowers, weed eaters, that kind of thing. But you know, a regular car, you don't really necessarily need to, because you usually drive it and run it out. But if a car's going to be sitting a while, try to have non-ethanol gas in it. It'll save from destroying your fuel system. there we go. We just got back from our drive, got the car covered up. We got the battery charged up, ran good. So we are going to leave it alone. We've got it covered up. Now the bad weather can come and she'll be safe and dry and charged up for that little rest it's going to be under. So anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.